As graphics cards continue to increase in price each generation, and as the aging AMD RX 500 series cards become cheaper and cheaper as miners offload their cards, would it be a good idea to consider Crossfire in 2020? Well, today we're going to find out by testing dual RX 570s in Crossfire. So to start off, the two Gaming X MSI RX 570s cost me 250 Canadian dollars, or about 180 US dollars. This is a rather low price for two graphics cards considering that a single mid-range 1660 Super would run you about 340 Canadian dollars or about 250 US dollars, while a 1650 Super would cost you about the same as the two RX 570s. The question is if the dual RX 570s are a better value than something like a 1650 or a 1660 Super. Considering the 1660 Super is about 50% faster, while the 1650 Super is about 25% faster than a single RX 570. This means that we need to see at least 50% and 25% scaling to justify the 570s over each card respectively. So on to the benchmarks. In Unigine's Heaven benchmark, we see the best case scenario for the 570s with 92% and 97% scaling in 1080p and 1440p respectively. This sort of scaling is far above the 50% needed to beat the 1660 Super. However, Heaven is only a synthetic benchmark, which means it's often not representative of real-world performance. So running Rise of the Tomb Raider, we see decent scaling with 48 and 64% observed in 1080p and 1440p respectively. These results are quite decent considering the 570s are outperforming the 1660 Super, which is $100 more expensive. Unfortunately, this was the best scaling observed in the games that were benched, and some games such as CSGO don't even support Crossfire. Although frame rates without Crossfire are still decent on the 570, it would often make more sense to opt for a more powerful single card that will consistently deliver its performance. This is when the disadvantages of Crossfire are really seen. There are simply far too many games like CSGO that just don't support Crossfire. Even worse, there are some games that run slower with Crossfire enabled. This was especially evident in Destiny 2, which scaled negatively with Crossfire on. The game averaged 78 and 54 frames in 1080p and 1440p respectively, with only a single RX 570. However, with Crossfire on, the game ran at a mere 45 and 33 frames per second, which represent a drop of 73 and 64% in 1080p and 1440p respectively. Although you can just turn off Crossfire in games with negative scaling, this also presents Crossfire with another problem, which is the hassle. With single card options, you can just launch the game and play, but on the other hand, you have to constantly be enabling and disabling Crossfire with the 570s to achieve decent results for each game that you play. Crossfire is also losing support in newer titles, which means that there will be a diminishing number of games that you will be able to run with Crossfire as time goes on. You don't even double your VRAM capacity with two cards, which means that you will still be limited to the 4GB VRAM buffer of the 570, even in Crossfire. The only benefit of Crossfire is its better performance in a sparse amount of games, such as Rise of the Tomb Raider. However, that is just not the case with most of the games today, as Crossfire just isn't what it was half a decade ago, where 70 to 90% scaling in games was frequent. In 2020, with Crossfire being slowly phased out, it is simply a much better choice to opt for the 1650 Super, which will deliver its performance consistently, hassle-free, rather than the dual 570s, which only yield substantially better results in occasional circumstances.